Welcome to RCTV's coverage, girls basketball, along with Dave Pence. I'm Bill Culp, and tonight, the Springford girls, the Rams, they host the Methacton Warriors. And Dave, it's a big matchup. Again, classic Pac-10 matchup.
Yeah, for sure. You know, Methacton's typically gives Springford the hardest games of the year. Methacton's been in the final seven times in the last 11 years, so they're going to be up there along with Springford, who's a constant powerhouse in the pack. So tonight's going to be a good matchup on senior night for the girls.
Yeah, congratulations to the seniors. We got to say, watching them out here, you know, just the achievements and, you know, the 4 years, it flies by, but it's a testament of how much work they put in and to the parents too.
Absolutely. So seniors tonight, Abby Boyer, Lucy Olson, Emily Tiffin, Mac Maloney, and Haley Hudak. So I probably would predict that they'll get the start, and you know, be good for the seniors to be out there. The senior leadership carries this team, and you know, one of our seniors is trying to chase Springford history.
Yes, she is. As you know, Olson is, I believe, we heard 36 points away from the all-time leader for the girls basketball, catching up to Stipa and a little over 60, and she's got Brock there. So she's definitely going to eclipse both of those sometime during the year. Maybe not tonight.
Maybe not tonight. We're not going to see her put up 60. Oh, it would be great if she did.
Oh.
But, you know, she's coming into this game averaging 19 points a game. So she's going to get her fair share of looks. And, you know, the first game, you know, all the games this year for Springford been blowouts. It's a matter of how much time is she going to get to play if the Springford Rams go up big early.
Yeah, definitely 3-0. But one of the things about Olson, I think, you know, she doesn't get enough credit for it. And you know this. You know, she's being a Upper Providence Elementary, you know, where we teach, an alum. But she's an incredible passer. She's tops. She's about to eclipse everybody in rebounds and assists. She's a very good passer with both hands.
Yeah, her court awareness, she is a special player, and she can do it on both ends, offense, defense. She can dish it out. She rebounds well. She's an all-out hustler out there. You know, she's just a coach's dream, basically, and her work ethic and everybody, and she leads by example out there in the court, and everybody else follows.
Yeah, and she really has. She has a nice cast with her, with Tiffin, who averages about 15 a game, and you know, she's got Anna, she's got Hudak in down low, and she's got Abby Boyer, who again is another great athlete. And these girls are phenomenal. They really are. They're fast, and they like to push the ball.
Yeah, and you know where Springford's staple, girls basketball, is their defense.
Mm-hmm.
Their defense creates easy layups and easy transition points, and that's going to happen again tonight. Springford puts a lot of pressure on the opposing team's guards.
Yes, and you're right, because looking at two of their three games so far there, Dave, gave up 24 points to Pottsgrove, only 24 points, and 28 to O&J Roberts. So that's defense.
Yeah, and I think it's going to continue tonight. Their defense is just stifling at times, and Mickey, you know, likes that full court press, a little trapping defense, and again, it just leads to a lot of easy transition baskets.
Yeah, definitely defense turning into offense there. You know, talk about that. You know, again, you mentioned probably most likely senior starting and this and that. Do you think even in these times, how does that, you know, do you think, talk about the emotional. They're probably experiencing tonight. They're probably a little bit more hyped.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough. You know, you get a young player on any, you know, player, you know, when you enter that senior season, it's kind of, when you're in it, you never look at it's going to end,
yeah.
You know, and when it does, it hits hard. So I think they're going to come out. They're going to play hard. They want to put on a good show and a good showing tonight, playing together, you know, for their last season, the five seniors. And, you know, and I'm looking forward to a good game out of all five of them.
Yeah, we're definitely looking forward to it. So we're going to send it up top to those big boys up there. I believe they're two seniors. And we'll see you guys at halftime. Enjoy the half.
May I please have an application? Thank you.
Skip the drama. Get your diploma. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
Wake the sun, tell him that I've begun. Hello, Springford, and welcome to Ram Nation Gymnasium. I am Edan Castillo alongside John Zawislak, and today the 3-0 Rams take on the 1-1 Warriors in a special senior night. John, tell me about Springford.
Yeah, Springford is 3-0 on the season. They're coming off of a 61-28 win against OJR. Some people to look out for: Lucy Olson, Emily Tiffin, Abby Boyer. Yeah, they're looking to get this win here tonight after just beating Methacton.
And tell me about Methacton.
Methacton is 1-1 on the season. Some players to watch are Nicole Timko and Cassidy Kropp, and they're coming off of a 75-32 win against Pottstown.
All right. Well, now we go to the national anthem. All right, this is a very high-stakes game, John. This could be a pivotal game for both of these teams. Springford sitting at 3-0, Methacton sitting at 1-1. And also, this is high emotions for Springford. This is a senior night, and, you know, these seniors, this is their time to shine.
Yeah, this is especially to open up the season. These teams played, and Springford came out on top. So you got to think Methacton's going to want to try and ruin their senior night and try and get back at them after beating them early on in the season. And this was also the Pack championship game last year. Springford came out on top, so Methacton definitely wants this win here tonight.
Yeah, Springford and Methacton, like, as you say, they have a history, a very recent history, and, you know, Methacton definitely wants to get back at Springford for the last two losses, as those losses were pivotal losses as it started the season and the Pack last year.
Yeah, something to look out for here tonight is Springford opened up the last game against Methacton in a full court press and ran out to an 8-1 lead. So let's look to see if Coach McDaniel does that again tonight.
Well, yeah, Springford always emphasizes on starting the game strong on defense, specifically in the paint, because they got Hudak in the paint who can always create some damage there. And, you know, Methacton, I'm sure all their focus is going to be to stop those main scorers on Springford, because there's a lot of them.
There is a lot of them. We're getting set here.
Tonight for Springford, all the seniors are starting, as it is the senior night. And like I said, this is going to be a high emotions here for Springford, as this is a big night for these girls.
And Another thing to look out for, Lucy Olsen only needs 36 points tonight to be the highest girl scorer in Spring Ford history. So that is a lot of points, but who knows?
Hey, 36 points. Look, all she needs is that motivation. She knows she needs 36 points. I guarantee you she's counting down. And if she can manage to put up 36 points tonight and break that record, it's going to be a night of history here at Spring Ford.
Imagine it on senior night, too. That'd be awesome.
That would be a historic night. Either way, if she reaches it or not today, she's going to hit it likely in the next two or three games. As the girls get ready for tip-off here on this Spring Ford senior night. Spring Ford wins the tip-off, and it goes to Mac.
Yeah, so what happened there on that play, Mac Maloney actually tore her ACL last spring, and she wasn't cleared for play yet, but they did a little ceremony because it's senior night. They let her come out and win the opening tip-off.
Yeah, you know, like I said, a lot of high emotions in this game. That was a moment that is going to be remembered here at Spring Ford as the tip-off goes to Methacton. As Kropp, it takes it at point, passes it out. Spring Ford is doing a great job keeping the ball at the perimeter, not letting anything get into the center, which is where Methacton is trying to get to. They're double teaming Kropp at the top, and that's a steal by Hudak on the ground, and that's a jump ball.
That's exactly Haley Hudak's play style. She loves to dive for those balls on the ground, reach it, and try and get it as hard as she can. That is something that is very usual to see from Haley Hudak.
As Olsen passes it in, and there's a whistle, and Spring Ford retains possession. The ball gets tossed in, out by the three-point line. Abby Boyer tosses it back out. Great passing here by Spring Ford, a floater, and it's in. Lucy Olsen, she's slowly inching her way to that record.
You see the Rams already starting that full court press.
As Kropp is trying to find an angle to get in, but she can't, and that's great defense. As the ball gets tipped out, Boyer's trying to sneak behind and steal the ball, but she can't. Methacton salvages that possession. But Springford with this really, really tight coverage as Kropp hits the ground hard, and that's going to be a foul on Springford.
That was actually a jump ball there. Anna Azazera was able to grab that ball while she was going up. They didn't call that one a foul there.
As the ball gets inbounded, immediately passed back to the inbounder. Again, they're trying to find a crease to get to the paint, but they just can't, as Springford's defense is just too tight in the perimeter, and they finally do, and a foul is called. As now, Methacton gets a chance at the line.
It's a great take right there by Allison Hazlett. Able to go up strong.
As Bachrath makes her first free throw as she is one of one, which gives Methacton their first point of the game. And she nails her second one. As now Olsen takes it up. She crosses over. She goes to the inside. A nice move, and Hudak hits the floor, and it's going to stay Methacton's ball.
And right there, Lucy, she got the lane. Just when she went to shoot it, she was just too far under the rim and couldn't really get that one in the net. And Hudak tried to keep it, but it bounced off her knee.
And Abby Boyer with great coverage. Hudak has it at the three-point line. Wide open. Goes in and out of the rim as Boyer with just outstanding defense. She's just in the face of the Methacton players the second they touch the ball in the backcourt. as Boyer does get a foul called on her, but all around great defense. Boyer again with that tight coverage, but Boyer ends up with the ball. And Hudak is calling for it. She's open down low, but she doesn't get the pass. And there's a whistle for a double dribble.
That was a great steal right there from Boyer. Reach from behind, able to get all of the ball. The ref was right there. It was a great call because that easily could have been called a foul right there. But she got her hand totally on the ball and got the steal.
Boyer has proven early in this game to be a strong defensive presence as Mithakdin tries to drive, but the ball gets taken out. It's a 3-on-1. Lucy Olsen's going to take it, and it's a foul. Lucy Olsen's going to get a chance at the line.
It's a great steal by Olsen. Just went right for the take at that right hand, but she got fouled from behind. It's a good job to draw the foul. Went up strong.
Absolutely. That was a 3-on-1 right there, so she had opportunities to pass it, but she decided to take it herself, and it proved to be worthy as she gets her chance at the free throw. She nails her first one. She drills the second one as well as Hudak hits the floor. Abby Boyer again with that tight coverage. It doesn't matter where she is on the court. She's going to be in the face of the ball carrier. Mithakdin again trying to find a way to get it inside the paint but can't. There's Olsen with the tight defense. The ball gets loose. Both players hit the ground and it's a jump ball. And that's all thanks to Lucy Olsen again. Getting the tip on that ball. This Springfield defense is resilient.
Yeah, they're diving after every ball that hits the floor.
Springfield takes it up. As it gets passed outside to Boyer, Boyer has a chance to shoot, hits the rim, and is kept in by Mithakdin. Mithakdin driving, trying to find any type of crease here against this tight Springfield defense. As number 44 passes it out, and it hits the front rim. As number 4 of Springfield passes it to number 11. She pump fakes, floater, and it goes off the front rim. That's a clear double dribble right there, and You heard it from the fans there.
Yeah, that was just one of those times where you pick up your dribble really quick, and then without thinking, you go to dribble again because you see the lane, and
it
just
looks
a double
like
dribble right there.
She couldn't decide whether she wanted to shoot or pass the ball in that situation, as Abby Boyer has the ball at the top of the key. As it gets passes, a three-point shot, bang!
That's a great shot right there by Emily Tiffin. In her last game, she had 4 3-pointers, led the entire game, so look for her to keep shooting from beyond the arc.
Tiffin is one who can do it all. She has the size. As a foul gets called there on Abby Boyer, that's her second one of the game. But Tiffin can do it all. You know, she can shoot it. She can shoot it from the outside. She has the size to score inside, so a great all-around basketball player. As Mithakdin gets their third and fourth attempt at the line. As they hit the first. And she hits her second as Mac Pettinelli checks in for Springford. Elizabeth Olsen takes it up. She pump fakes. She passes it back out. Another pump take. Passes it. Inside, Hudak has her crease. She can't get it in. She puts it too tough on the glass there.
It's a great block right there by Mari Smith from Mithakdin, able to reach from behind and get all ball.
Hudak was able to get her hand in the Mithakdin player's face there to cause that shot not to go in as Lucy Olsen takes a mid-range shot, hits it. As Olsen is, she's just shredding the defense today. She's doing what she always does. She's proven to be unstoppable today. Hudak is playing very physical basketball, and she gets a jump ball. What an outstanding job by Hudak there. That's what she does.
What? Once again, just diving on the floor for it. This entire Rams defense, Rams team is just jumping on every ball on the ground. You love to see it.
Hudak has just that. She has this fire in her. Whenever she sees the ball gets passed anywhere near her, she's gonna jump on the ball, and that's what she's done already several times in only the first couple minutes of today's game. As Mithactin tosses the ball in to Kropp. Kropp is looking. She puts a nice move, a floater, and it goes off the glass. Olsen gets shoved there, and it's going to be Springford's ball here.
Now, it's just one of those cases where you see a loose ball. Olsen was able to get to it first, and she wasn't able to stop herself, ran into her. Just a nice basketball. Not a good foul, but...
And they find Olsen at the top of the key. Olsen's going to make a nice move, and she's not going to get anything as she was well defended there. Oh, that was a really ill-advised pass. That's going to be stolen by Springford and taken all the way to the rim. As Mithactin's going to take a timeout after that one. That was just she just didn't see the Springford defender run up there and steal that pass.
Yeah, that's a great defensive play right there. And as Azera was ready for the pass, had her head up. The Mithactin player got a little lazy, passed it across, and it was right there. Got the steal, went up nice with the right hand strong, and got the basket. 3 o'clock, Springford out to a nice start right here, up 11-4.
Oh yeah, that was an outstanding start as Mithactin was forced to take a timeout there. I mean, we saw everything that we expected from Lucy Olsen as she had a fantastic start to this first quarter, and Mithactin really had no answers. Springford, on the other hand, man, I mean, that defense is all over the place.
Mithactin's only points have come from four free throws by Tori Bockrath. Let's see if they can try and draw something up here to get some points through the basket.
It's clear Mithactin is trying to get inside the paint. They've not really attempted a three yet, but Springford is not letting that happen. As look, they come out ready to steal the ball on the inbound. Springford is giving them no room to breathe, and that's a block. Outstanding block at the three-point line, and that's another steal by Olsen as she passes it inside, and that's a foul.
Yeah, that play right there is set up by Tiffin on the defensive side, blocked the three-pointer. They tried to go up again for the second shot. Olsen got the steal, pass it down to Tiffin. She was able to get up to the hoop, go up strong, and get these free throws.
As Tiffin's going to attempt her first free throw of the game. And she hits it. Check in for Rams, number 33, Jules Scalia. As Tiffin nails her second. And the ball gets deflected again by Tiffin, as Tiffin's just all over the place defensively. And that's a block. Olsen retains possession of the ball. She's going to bring it down. She passes it out. It's a wide open three. It goes off the back rim. They pass it back inside, but that ball is tipped, and Mithactin retains possession. Mithactin finally finds a way to get it to the inside, but that's a block by Olsen. Olsen's just all over the court today, as that's a gorgeous pass, and even a prettier block. My goodness.
What a swat right there by Tori Bockrath. Got a beautiful pass from Olsen from all the way on the other side of the court. Got it to Anna Adizera. There's nothing really she could do there. She went up strong. Just Bockrath came from behind her and swatted her.
That was a gorgeous block. Just committing to it. All right, as Tiffin has it at the three-point line, as they pass it all around the three-point line, all the other side, Olsen shoots, and she misses, but there's a whistle on the floor. As Springford is going to get free throw shots. Excuse me, they're going to inbound the ball.
It seems like that one was on the floor after the play. Tori Bockrath took the foul there.
Olsen's going to inbound the ball. She's going to get it to Tiffin at the top of the key. She passes it back inside, a beautiful fadeaway that doesn't go in, but Springford somehow gets the rebound. It's back out to Tiffin. Tiffin wide open for three. Bang! Emily Tiffin. absolute gorgeous play design by Springford as Tiffin has the ball again, and she's just going to bring that in. As that was a great series of events there by Springford. As they're up 18-4, and that's what you call a first quarter blowout right there.
What a great sequence for Tiffin. Hit the three, get the steal, make the layup. That's a five-point swing right there.
Olsen with a pretty pass across the court that's set up for a three that goes out of bounds, and it's going to be Methacton's ball. As Pettinelli checks in for the Rams. As there is a, as that was a flat foul on the floor against Springford, as Methacton is going to get a chance to inbound with 32 seconds left on the quarter.
Yeah, Tiffin just came over to try and help and took the block foul there.
Methacton is going to take it up, trying to find anything before the quarter ends. As Olsen plays tight defense, but they find a way to get in the middle, and there's another foul. As Methacton is looking to extend their points to six with only free throws in the quarter.
That was a beautiful pick and roll by Bachrath and Hazlitt. Hazlitt set the pick.
As the six-foot senior gets her first attempt at a free throw, and she drills it.
Back in for the Warriors, Mari Smith.
As Smith checks in for the Warriors. And she makes her other one on a bounce as Methacton grows their points to six. All by free throws, as Olsen is going to pass the ball all the way to the bottom of the key. It's gonna go back out to the three-point line. All the way back to Olsen, who just does a touch pass. Back to Tiffin. Springford's passing game is just all over the place. Back to the inside, wide open in the key, and she can't finish. As that is the end of the first quarter. And it's 18-6 for Springford, and we're going to go into commercial break.
What are you, superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Welcome back, and we have a very entertaining second quarter ahead of us as Springford is leading Methacton 18-6, and Springford's going to look to extend that lead, and Methacton's going to look for anything as their only 6 points has come through free throws.
On the bright side, they're 6-for-6 from the free throw line, so that's nice.
100% from the free throw, but I guess also 100% from field goal percentage because they haven't taken any shots, or they haven't. Excuse me, I take that back. That was just bad math on my part. As Olsen takes a shot from the three. It hits off the top of the rim. Hudak somehow gets her hands on it. And there is a tussle for the ground on the ground, and that's a jump ball. Excuse me, Methacton would have a 0% field goal percentage, which is what I was attempting to say earlier. Springford's going to have the opportunity to inbound here. Never mind. Methacton's going to have a chance to inbound here as the refs changed their decision last second there. As Boyer's in the face of the player. And Boyer comes up with the ball. That was a great defensive play by Olsen. And Springford capitalizes it as Azera comes up with the points. Methacton driving. There's a whistle, and that's a travel. So their first opportunity to get a basket there was ruined by a travel.
And that's a great play by Azera there, able to reach in, make her stumble, and then take those extra steps to force the travel.
Azera, who passes it back out to Olsen, who's trying to set up a play here. She passes it out to Boyer, back out to Olsen. Olsen pump fakes. She passes it inside to Hudak. Hudak with a quick pass out to Boyer. Olsen with the mid-range, and she hits it. She's just an unstoppable machine today. She's trying to break the record today, I guarantee it. Boyer with tight defense on the perimeter. Hudak comes up. Azera follows Olsen. Hudak is out in the perimeter. As Methacton tries to post up Azera and they bank it, finally gets a point that wasn't from a free throw as Olsen takes it up. She's wasting no time, passes it out to Azera. Olsen calling for the ball. Olsen shoots, she hits. Man, Olsen is just, she's just unstoppable.
It's also just great passing by the Rams offense, able to work it around, get Olsen open, able to find her and let her hit that shot.
Boyer hits the ground there as Methacton is trying to find any crease on this spring four defense as they take a deep three and hit. Methacton is finding their stride here as they're trying to make any type of comeback. Olsen fakes a pass, passes it out to Boyer. Boyer drives in, and that was just a bad pass that into Methacton's hands as Methacton's going to have another chance to put up more points. Methacton passes it back out. They're all over the Methacton offense here. As they drive, Hudak with great defense, passes it inside, and that's going to be a foul.
It's another great job by Hazlitt getting to the line for her second time. Just going up strong and drawing the foul. She was 2 for 2 her last time.
As she hits her first, as Methacton extends their lead, extends their points to 12. And John, what about Lucy Olsen today?
Yeah, she's playing a great game right now. That's also attributed to some of the play that all the other Spring Four players able to pass it around. It's almost like they know where they're going with the ball two passes ahead of time. It's crazy how fast that ball goes around. And Olsen's just, like you said, on fire, hitting every shot she takes.
Well, speak of the devil, Lucy Olsen has the ball, as who else would on Springford right now? As she's going to do what she's going to do and pass it out to Tiffin, and she's going to hit, as that's an assist for Olsen and a three-point shot from Tiffin, as this Springford offense is hitting on all cylinders right now. Boyer, who's had an outstanding defensive first quarter, is going to pass. And that's going to be a travel call on Methacton as Springford's going to get the ball right back. And, man, I don't know how you're going to stop this Springford offense right now as you see Olsen take up the ball again. Olsen trying to find room. She's double-teamed. Why wouldn't she be? Pass it out to Olsen. Olsen trying to set up a play and reset. Olsen taking her time. Passes it out to Boyer. Back to Olsen. Out to Tiffin. Out to Boyer. This passing game is on fire right now. Back out to Olsen. They can't find a crease right now to score. But there's Hudak in the middle and can't finish. Hudak calls for a foul but doesn't get one.
What a great pass. Also a great job by Olsen was directing traffic while she had the ball, told Hudak to cut to the right. She was wide open, just couldn't finish.
as Mathacton takes it to the rim as they get a nice floater there. As Olsen takes it up, she finds a wide open Boyer, but the pass was a little off. But we got a long two, and that's a hit from Pennellini. So who's going to miss on the Springford offense?
Not really sure right now. They're on fire.
As Mathacton's trying to find a way to keep pace with this offense, I'm not sure they can. Mathacton looking a way to get the ball inside the paint. That's a nice move, but it ends up resulting in a loss as Tiffin's going to get the ball. This is a two-on-one. Tiffin takes it to the basket but can't finish. As Mathacton resets here, a pass to the outside. Trying to get it to the inside. Mathacton passes it back to the outside. That pass was a little off, unless it could have been an open three, but this is, and she misses. Olsen is going to look for Hudak down low, who's wide open, and finishes.
A great pass from Olsen. Another great job as well from Hudak. Waited a little bit for the Mathacton defender to jump up, let her jump, and then took the shot.
Abby playing tight coverage on the outside. Passes it outside. Tiffin gets a hand on it. And Olsen gets another hand on it. And they're going to keep it at Mathacton's ball. As Olsen was the last one to touch that. Mathacton to inbound. She takes it down low, and that's a foul, as the Ram Nation doesn't like that call.
Yeah, Boyer wanted the jump ball there. It was similar to a couple of other times that she's grabbed it before she could jump up, and they've called it the jump ball, but this time they call it a foul.
She hits her first opportunity as... Mathacton surprisingly maintains their 100% from the free throw, as it's pretty impressive considering how much they've taken. And they continue that streak as Mathacton takes a timeout, and what an outstanding performance by Springford in their offense. They're just not missing right now.
Yeah, they are not missing right now. On Mathacton, they're 10 for 10 from the free throw line, Mathacton. 10 for 10 right now. That is crazy good.
It's impressive, but also considering that they've only scored 17 points in the game, it's a little concerning that their offense can't get going. And considering how high-powered the Springford offense is, Mathacton needs to figure out something.
Yeah, they're going to have to try and take some more shots. Go up stronger, get to the free throw line a little bit more. Because if you're shooting like this, you want to get to the free throw line as often as possible. But for Springford, you just got to keep putting it on them. You're up by 15. It's your senior night. I know sometimes you can lose your head a little bit and just focus on, like, messing around or something like that. But you want to stay focused. You're up by 15. Just focus on the game.
And you know what? You know, we're talking about how high-powered the Springford offense is right now. We're not talking about their defense. I mean, Boyer has already accumulated a few steals, same as Tiffin, same as Olsen, as they're just as good on defense as they are on offense, as they're clearly approaching this full court defense approach, and it's working. As we come back from the timeout, Springford's going to inbound it to Olsen. Olsen taking her time again, trying to find where to put the ball. She passes it out to Tiffin. Back to Zara, who takes the shot and hits the front of the rim. Passes it back to Zara, who attempts a free throw. And Hudak couldn't come up with the rebound. As here comes Mathacton. As the ball is tipped out of the hand. Trying to get her way around Olsen. She can't. Hudak with strong defense at the perimeter, but it doesn't matter as the pass gets through, and it's a layup from Mathacton. Olsen takes it up. She drives. She passes it out. Wide open three. She doesn't hit. As we're going to get a whistle. And Methacton's going to inbound.
Acton's in the 1-1 here. That's why they're going to the free throw line.
Let's see if Methacton continue their free throw streak. And they do.
This is just getting crazy right now.
Look, as you said, you know, coming out of that timeout, you got to make sure, you know, Springford keeps their head in the game. And if she hits this free throw, which she does, all of a sudden the lead is down to 11, which is very manageable, especially considering we have another half. But Olsen wants to make sure it's not 11 as she gets her own rebound and nearly hits an and one, but she's going to get a chance at the line.
Man, that ball did not want to fall. Hit three sides of the rim and just fell right out. Another thing you want to watch out for is Thacton is in the bonus, like we said, and if they just keep getting these fouls and keep getting to the line, they could rack up some points here.
Olsen's going to hit her first free throw. And she will hit her second. And Methacton is trying to put up some last-minute points, literally, as we are approaching the last minute of the half. They pass it out, trying to find any crease on Springford. A floater that's blocked by Hudak. Olsen is trying to develop a fast break here. She does Euro step, roll, and nearly hits the hand one again, but she's going to get another two attempts at the line.
Just a great take right there, able to go for the Euro step. Goes to the outside on the left, goes up strong, gets the foul, and that ball just does not want to fall.
You know, considering, you know, in the NBA, in the WNBA, how much as Olsen hits her first free throw at the line, considering how, you know, how big the Eurostep has become in professional sports, it's even come full circle here at high school sports as Olsen attempted one right there. That would have been a sweet move and an and one if she hit it. Results in 2 points anyway. As Olsen attempts to tip the ball there. As that's a steal by Olsen with 30 seconds left. It's a 2-on-2. Olsen puts it up. She doesn't get the foul, but she gets her own rebound. Passes it back out. And that's an easy mid-range two for Springford as they just extended their lead to 38-21. As Methacton is going to try to get anything with the last 15 seconds in the half. Methacton passes it outside. Mid-range two, and they hit theirs. 5 seconds, 4-3. Olsen's going to attempt a half-court shot. Oh, and nearly rolls in. All right, well, we are headed to a special halftime show with Mr. Culp and Mr. Pence up in the studio, and we will see you back here for the third quarter. I'm Edan Castillo alongside John, and we will see you back here in the third.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to RCTV's coverage here, halftime again with Boyertown Hall of Famer Dave Pence. I'm Bill Culp, and it's been a hectic first half, so Springford coming out, and you know, one of the things I noted, as you mentioned pregame there, Dave, the defense, and they came out pressing, and right away on the first possession, swallowed it up. Hudak on the ground, classic Springford defense.
Yeah, I mean, it was stifling. You know, they forced 11 turnovers in that first half, and they protected the ball well. Springford only turned the ball over three times, so Coach McDaniel, he's going to be real happy with that, but. You know, to start out that first half, we saw, you know, a really class act. We had Mac Maloney tore ACL last spring, still not cleared to play. You know, I'm sure there's a little bit of a coach's agreement, player's agreement, where she was able to start the game, be on the floor, and be on the floor for that first tip at one senior night. So what a special moment by Mac Maloney, and I'm not sure what her timetable is getting back, but hopefully she can get back soon.
Yeah, so like I said, Springford, it started out on both sides. Really, both teams really couldn't find their offense early. Springford took a real big lead there. Tiffin and Olsen carrying it there in the first quarter, with Olsen having six and Tiffin leading the way with 10. So they were really controlling the offense today.
Yeah, I mean, it was 18-6 after the first quarter. Methacton didn't even have a field goal. I mean, All their 6 points in the first quarter came on free throws. So, you know, again, every shot Methacton takes is just challenged. You know, they have a hand in their face. They're forcing some shots, and Springford's defense is the staple of their game, is coming through tonight in a big, big way.
Yeah, and you mentioned that for Methacton. That's what's keeping them in this game is free throws, over half of their points. And they're perfect from the line tonight with 13 for 13. So that's 13 points, and that helped them climb back into this game as Springford, again, Abby Boyer picking up a couple fouls and Hudak picking up a couple fouls. So that's kept Methacton into the game.
Yeah, I mean, and it's impressive. Abby Boyer's the leader out there, especially on that full court press. She just is all over the place. She just harasses everyone. She picked up two big fouls immediately in that first quarter, and Coach McDaniel had no choice but to take her out, but they didn't miss a beat. It just shows you the depth of some of the players coming off the bench and filling in quality minutes for the Springford Rams, as one of the senior leader has to sit on the bench early in this game.
Yeah, you mentioned that. Like you said, you set me up perfectly there with the perfect lob. So Pettinelli coming in with 6 points off the bench, all coming in that second quarter. So giving them some good minutes there.
Yeah, great minutes. I mean, you think about Azara and Pettinelli, two freshmen are getting significant playing time, and not just playing time, but contributors, both offense and defensively. So it's great to see that from some young players that are, you know, going to take the reins of this senior core that's going to be leaving after this year. So it's really good to see, you know, the depth that Springford's able to put on the court.
Yeah, like you said, I mean, you have four seniors starting for Springford coming back tonight. So to see all those freshmen, and they got size too. They're athletic, but they have the size to see that contribution. Coach McDaniel's got to be excited for the future.
Oh, absolutely excited for the future. So if we look at the now, you know, the two senior leaders, we have Olsen and Tiffin. Olsen has 15, and, you know, Tiffin has 13 in this first half. Great contributions there. So, you know, we just want to see more of the same. I'd like to see them shoot a little bit better from the three, beyond 3 point. They're only 4 of 11. I guess not all too bad,
yeah,
but not typical for Springford. Usually a little bit better behind the arc. But their defense is where it's at tonight.
Yeah, and consistency right now, you know, again, scoring 18 that first quarter. They did score 20 in the second quarter. So, you know, there is that balance there. And as you mentioned, the three-pointers, usually they are second half three-point shooting team.
Yeah, they usually heat up down the line. So it'd be interesting to see if this lead holds up again. They're off to a big lead. How much foot on the gas does Coach McDaniel have out there and keep them going and keep it full throttle? Or is he going to bring in some other people to get some more experience for some of the younger players in this game? And that's kind of seems probably the biggest challenge Mickey McDaniel has in this early going of the season. How long does he go with his starters?
Yeah.
So it would be interesting to see. But we know that Methacton does have some scoring threats. They have some players that can create problems, especially in Timko. If she starts heating up, they could bring them back in a hurry.
Yeah, and you mentioned, I think one of the other challenges for Coach McDaniel is, and we talk about this all the time, I know he loves defense, but he's got Olsen who can literally take it anytime she wants, and I'm not saying score, but set up for an easy shot. And sometimes we're watching that offense where they're running it out in the three-point. You know, sometimes I think, you know, to release, let the reins go and let her just create, because she's in. We saw some phenomenal passes where they didn't finish all the time, but some beautiful passing.
Yeah, she does it all, and it looks like a lot of times she was just looking to pass.
Yeah.
And we can see the quick outlet pass, looking up, you know, hit Tiffin a couple times. Azara, you know, looking, keeping her head up. She can see the floor so well. Like, and that's what makes her that special player. She can see the floor and make everybody around her better. And she was doing that. She was looking for the open passes, and she's quick on the trigger in those passes, getting them down low to her teammates. And you know, not always finishing, but that's okay. You know, it's just neat to see how she can just run the floor and make everybody around her better.
Yeah, and you mentioned the word quick. I mean, quick just describes this defense. And again, we watched from the beginning, and that explains, like you said, six free throws from Mathacton. Again, scoring more in the second quarter, but that stifling defense, they pick you up as soon as you get past half court. How tiring is that
tiring, for an offense? Tiring, frustrating. You have to earn every inch of that hardwood out there when you play spring forward, and it just wears them down. And we, like I said, we could see it in the 11 turnovers in the first half by Mathacton. Give or take a few, I might even miss some. There were so many. It's just impressive that the condition the girls are in for spring four, because they don't look exhausted at all.
No, and you mentioned, again, the conditioning. And for Mathacton, you were mentioning before the game, Mathacton's got good size. So that's a lot of huffing and puffing out there for, especially for, you know, for the girls that are taller and bigger and probably not used to that up and down and that constant press.
Yeah, when you have that constant press, everybody has to get involved. You can't just run down and stand at the low box and wait for a pass from the perimeter to come into you. You got to be a part of it. If not, there's just going to be more turnover. So it forces everybody from Mathacton to get involved, run the court. And then the worst part about it is the turnovers. They got to stop, turn around, and run back the other way because of the transition game. So it puts a tremendous amount of pressure on their opponents.
Yeah, and again, and kind of going back, the nice thing with that pressure is it's constant because, as you mentioned, Coach McDaniel's got a lot in the basket. He's got a lot. You see that constant sub, as you mentioned, freshman, younger classmen. He has no fear about putting them in those crucial minutes.
No, not at all. And we saw it early. You know, the girls. Now, we have to also remember, a lot of these girls played traveled basketball since they're 8, 9 years old. So they have a lot of experience in some big-time tournaments where they played together moving up. I mean, a lot like we were talking before this game, you know, we've seen a lot of them come through Upper Providence. Some of our former students, Mac Pentinelli, she was in my class. I know she played a lot of travel basketball. Great student, great kid, good work ethic. And it's paying off for it, playing those travel basketball games. So when they get put on this stage, it's not too big for them.
You talk about traveling. We're going to travel upstairs to Edon and John for second half action. We'll see you post game, Dave and I. So enjoy the second half, everybody.
Morning, Gary. We are getschooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
That's why we're here. We're free and here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with attendance. Gary, financial aid forms. Picking a college, man. You and us go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Go to getschooled.com.
Hello, welcome back to Spring Ford versus Mathacton basketball game. Not football. It's January, and Spring Ford leads 38-23. And Lucy Olson has had a fantastic first half. As she's gonna inbound the ball or receive the inbound the ball, and Tiffin passes it back outside to Hudak, back out to Olsen. Olsen thinks about the three, doesn't take it. She takes the mid-range, doesn't hit. Olsen, very close to hitting her record. We're not sure about tonight, but she's very close.
Only needs 22 more.
As Mathacton attempts a more aggressive attempt here to start the half, they don't hit. Olsen is going to take it all the way. She can't hit the layup. As Mathacton is they attempt a 2-on-1, but they can't hit on the layup. Boyer is taking it up, finds Olsen. Olsen trying to set something up. As they find Tiffin. Olsen outside, takes her time to hit the three. And she's inching her way to that record. Again, it's going to take a monster performance in this half, but do you think she can do it?
I don't know. It's going to be tough. She's got to have a good third quarter here.
Well, she's had the right start for it as Methacton is keeping it at the three-point line as they are driving in. And that's a clean block by Hudak, and that's going to end up being Methacton's ball. But Hudak coming out of nowhere.
What a great block by Hudak right there, able to step up and reach her arm. She has those long arms able to reach and knock that ball out of bounds.
As Methacton inbounds, they take it back out. Trying to find a way to get inside the paint. But Olsen is way too tight on the coverage. Good luck going up against Olsen. As Azara moves on. Methacton trying to find a way to get to the basket as she does, but that's going to be a foul on Hudak as she prevented Methacton from getting a clean look at the board. But here comes more attempts from the free throw from Methacton.
12 for 12 in that first half. Let's see if it carries over here.
And it won't. As
looks
that
like,
breaks
like I
the
jinxed
record.
It.
Let's see if she goes for one here at the line. She does. As the ball goes back out to Olsen. Let's see what more damage the Springford offense can generate as she passes it out to Tiffin. Tiffin wide open, and she's going to hit it. There is no stopping this offense right now. As Azara hits the ball, and it's going to retain. Oh, never mind. The ref changed his mind real quick as it's going to remain Remith Acton's ball.
That is Tiffin's 4-3 this game. She is knocked down from beyond the arc right now.
As Olsen is just going to steal that inbound, and it looks like she's going to have a lane to drive, and that's a clean block. That was an outstanding block from behind on Olsen. As Methacton tries to go down, and Olsen just blocks the ball right back to her face, and Boyer comes up with the rebound, but passes it back in, and Methacton gets their hands on the ball as they're trying to find a way into the basket as somebody's trying to maintain possession as Boyer comes up with it. Boyer is going to pass it out to Olsen. Olsen out to Azara. Azara with the floater, and it rolls in. Again, who's going to miss on the Springford offense? Azara, excuse me. As Boyer with the tight defense that gets brought to the basket and it goes off the backboard. Olsen is bringing it up, passes it up to Azara. She does the floater and doesn't go in, and that's a foul on Springford.
That was Hudak just trying to be aggressive right there, trying to get the rebound. Just a little shove.
As Springford is double teaming, and that's going to be a foul on Springford. And that's going to be on Azara. Azara, by the way, a starter, well, not necessarily a starter tonight because Mac came in for her honorary tip-off, but She is starting for the majority of the game, and she's a freshman. So great start for her career here at Springford as Tiffin looks for a crease. Hudak is going to take the long two, goes off the back of the back of the rim. Boyer is trying to find a way to steal the ball, and she does. She gets a tip, but it's going to remain Methacton's ball.
Great job by Boyer there. She saw the Methacton player dribbling a little bit, saw the ball, was able to reach for it, and knock that ball out of bounds. Great defensive play.
Boyer has that game-breaking speed that if she comes up from behind you, the ball is most likely going to get tipped. As Methacton's going to get the opportunity to end down. They do. As they keep it at the perimeter. As they drive, and she's going to hit the deck. and that's going to be a shooting foul. And that's Abby Boyer's third, I believe, as she's going to have to be subbed out.
That's actually her fourth, so if she gets one more, she's out of the game. So they're probably, they're definitely going to sit her down, wait, let her sit for a little bit. Definitely don't want to lose her.
No, especially considering her defensive presence today. As Methacton's going to inbound. The ball is being passed around the perimeter, trying to find any crease, pretends to pump fake, but didn't really do much as the ball goes out of bounds and it's going to stay Spring Ford's possession. Spring Ford is leading 46-24 as we are approaching the 3-minute mark in this third quarter. Olsen is trying to find where to go with the ball. Back out to Olsen at the perimeter. Olsen making a move towards the basket behind, but it hits the bottom of the backboard, and that's going to be a jump ball.
Nielsen tried to get baseline there, go up, go under the basket, just wasn't able to get out far enough when she went up for the shot.
Methacton's going to inbound here. Let's see if Methacton can get anything going in this third quarter as they pass it on the inside. And what a block by Olsen as Olsen passes it to Tiffin. Tiffin with the lane, and she's going to finish. And that all started with the block from Olsen, and now she tips the ball out of bounds. She is all over the court.
Great job by Olsen there. Like you said, got the steal, saw Tiffin on the break. Perfect pass. Tiffin able to go up with the left hand and lay that one right in.
How about that Olsen-Tiffin duo?
Yeah,
I mean,
they're
just on par today.
They both have 18 tonight. Tied for the lead in the game.
And you know, a lot of that is 4 years of chemistry. That is years of working together. I mean, even before that, I'm sure they played in middle school together. As Methacton hits a three. And that was a timely three as they needed that. As Azara brings up the ball.
That's Timko's second
Olsen
three of the game.
Olsen sets a screen. She gets the ball. Back to Azara. Back out to Olsen. Olsen thinks about the three. She doesn't take it. She instead goes in for the finger roll.
And able to just walk right in. No one really knew who to take her. Able to just walk right in for that easy layup.
We've seen Olsen a few times today use that pump fake as Methacton's going to take a mid-range two. And the ball gets stuck in between the rim and the backboard. And it's time to use another ball to release the first ball.
Man, that's got to be.
And it works.
Perfect placement. Put the ball at the perfect right spot to land right there in between the rim. I mean, that's maybe the second time that I've ever seen that happen here at Springfield. But I've had that happen to me a couple times playing some street ball.
You know, we might talk about player of the game here. We might talk about Olsen or anybody else here, Tiffin. But I think the player of the game has to go to that ref because if it wasn't for her, the ball would still be up in that rim as Olsen draws a foul. And she's going to get two attempts at the free throw. Lucy Olsen drills her first attempt. And makes her second. As Springford has a 23-point lead right now, Methacton is really looking for a crease here. And that's going to be a floater that Lucy Olsen tries to get the rebound, but goes out of bounds. And Methacton is going to retain possession here. Methacton on the inbound. As Tiffin with great defense, and it's going to end up with Springford's ball. Warriors, Olsen taking up the ball. Passes it out to Azera. She gets a screen. Azera's going to get a nice look. She doesn't hit. Nathakton's moving at a much faster pace now. They feel the pressure. But that's going to be a nice block as she's trying to get the ball out. And Springford is going to get the ball to Olsen. Olsen finds Azera at the three-point line, and she can't hit. And that's going to be a foul on Springford. As Hudak checks in.
That was Tiffin's fourth foul, so they're going to sit her out. Don't want to lose her either. She's having a great game.
This is where Mathakton needs to take advantage. Now Boyer is out and Tiffin. This is where you got to take advantage. Get as many points up as you can. Try to form a comeback here. Mathakton finds a way to the basket, but that's blocked again. There were maybe two hands on that ball. As Hudak's calling for the ball down low, they don't find her. A nice move to the inside. And she's going to hit.
What a great pass from Pettinelli, able to get it to Skonia down low, wide open for that easy left-handed layup.
It's all about the Springford passing game. That's what it's about today. Oh, that's a clear travel on Mathakton, and Springford's going to get the ball back here. Again, it looked like one of those situations where she didn't know if she wanted to pass or stop, and just resulted in a travel. Olsen's getting double-teamed. Azera at the top. Mathakton's doing a good job as they end up with the steal. This is a two-on-one. Mathakton is going to get the ball, and that's a clear walk again. That's the second travel in a row as we have 9 seconds left in the third quarter.
Yeah, Timko tried to go for that long two-step jump and layup, but accidentally took that third step. Going to be a travel there.
Especially on fast breaks, it's very easy to find yourself taking a step or two more than you need to. As Springford is trying to get the ball off with 2-1, and she misses everything. And that's going to be it for the third quarter. We got one quarter left to go. Let's go to commercial break, John.
May I please have an application? Thank you.
Skip the drama. Get your diploma. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
Welcome back to Springford versus Mathakton. Springford's leading 54-27 here at home. And the big story is Lucy Olsen has taken a seat as she's only 15 points off from tying the record. And she got close today, but she's probably going to hit that next game on Monday.
And she got close tonight, but they're going to definitely just sit her out for the rest of this game.
As that's going to be a call on Mathakton, as Springford's going to get the ball right back. As they pass it into the freshman, Azara. Azara passes it to Hudak. Hudak back outside. Back out to Azara at the point. Trying to find the crease at the... Wow, what a beautiful turnaround jumper there. And Springford, doesn't matter who's in the game. They're going to hit. They're going to hit on all shots.
They're doing a great job of knocking these inside shots down.
And that's going to be a reach on Springford, as that was a pretty clear call. And Mithacton's going to get more chances here at the line.
That's going to be Mithacton's in the bonus again here. That was Springford's seventh foul, so they're going to get these free throws here.
I mean, most of their points came from the free throw line, so let's see if they can add on to that, as they can't. As Hudak comes up with the rebound. Back out to Azara. Hudak calling for the ball. Looking to pass. Bass out, back outside. Passes it back inside. Trying to find Hudak. Hudak triple teamed there. Springford trying to find a way, but Mithacton has a good defensive stand, and it's going to end up remaining Springford's ball.
And Kylie Lee tried to get that one to the cutting Azara, but it was knocked out there by Mithacton.
Petalini is going to inbound. She gets it in to the perimeter. Azara passes it back outside. Great passing by Frank Springford. Wide open three. That's not going to result in a shot, but we got a whistle on the floor. And it's going to remain Springford's ball. Wow, it seems like Springford has set possession here for like 2 minutes. As Lucy Olsen checks back into the game. As I didn't expect that to happen, but here she is. As maybe she's going to take one last shot in the final 6 minutes to tie that record. Passes it back out wide open. As Lucy Olsen's going to get the rebound, and that's 2 points closer to that record.
And Kylie Lee took the three-pointer there. It was a pass right to Lucy Olsen.
As Mithacton missed the three, they're trying to drive in. They get a clear look, but Hudak draws the foul there. As that's Hudak's third, and Mithacton's going to get more opportunities here at the line, as if they didn't have enough, right? Mithacton hits their first. And Boyer's going to check in. Springford is putting in their starters again as for the final stretch here in their senior night. As this is a pretty historic game for these girls, as this is going to be a game that they're going to want to bring with them and remember for the rest of their lives.
Yes,
as Olsen brings up the ball. Olsen passes it out to Boyer. And remember, Boyer is and Tiffin. They both have one foul left to give before they are removed from the game. As Tiffin is double-teamed, Olsen's wide open, and Tiffin's knocked to the floor. Tiffin's going to inbound. Olsen going to bring the ball up. She's going to make a move, step back. Beautiful shot.
What
my
a take
goodness.
Right there. Wow.
I'm telling you, she knows how close she is.
Only needs 10 more to tie it.
I've seen crazier things happen. And that's going to be an and one. As Mithacton has a opportunity for a four-point play. And that might just be the energy they needed. As the entire bench erupted as that happened. And it is, in fact, a four-point play. What an outstanding shot. As Olsen trying to shift the momentum back to Springford here. And she's going to find Hudak. Gets it back to Olsen. Olsen making a move. mid-range floater. Hudak with an impressive rebound, but she can't hold on to it. She falls back on it, and that's going to be a jump ball. And it's going to remain Springford's ball. As Tiffin's going to inbound the ball. Get it out to Hudak at the three-point line. Olsen passes it into Tiffin. Back out to Olsen. Thinks about the three. Instead, takes the floater, and she's going to hit. And she's just on fire right now. She's not going to miss anything.
They're able to fake that three-point shot, get the defender to jump it, and take the nice, easy floater.
And Mathakton's not going to be able to hit on that shot, and Olsen's going to get another opportunity to score here. Olsen's driving. She's going to take it all the way to the rim. Can't finish. Hudak's going to take that back out. Tiffin wide open. Oh, hits on the rim. Does Hudak get another rebound? She nearly does. And it's going to rain Springford's ball. That's all Hudak right there. Hudak has, if I were to give a hustle award here, it would be Hudak's award to give.
That was a great hustle play by Hudak.
Olsen's going to inbound the ball. Boyer's wide open out there. She's going to pass it, and that ball goes off the hands of Springford. Mathakton's going to take that ball all the way down, and it's going to be a blocking foul on Boyer. And Boyer is going to be removed from the game, as that was her fifth foul.
Yeah, that one was a close one right there. Tried to take the charge, just couldn't get her feet set.
As in comes Azar to replace her. And, that's not the way Boyer wanted to end her senior night, but she had a fantastic, fantastic game all around on defense specifically.
Yeah, most definitely. She had a great game. Nothing to hang your head about.
As they're going to get this one to Olsen with, we just hit the 4-minute mark. Olsen spins. She can't hang on to the ball. Olsen frustrated about that one. Or maybe one slip up of today's game. Springford playing tight. Mathakton trying to find anything as she finds her way all the way to the basket. Olsen drawing up a play. Passes it out to Tiffin. Tiffin takes the shot. Goes back out to Hudak. Olsen figuring out what to do. She passes it to Hudak. Hudak out back out to Azara. Olsen calling for it. Olsen drives, and she's going to get a clear lane, and Olsen's going to finish. And she is 6 points, 6 points away from tying the record with 251. That's 2 threes to tie the record. This could be a historic night for Springford if she can do it. Hudak in the face. Olsen. As Mathakton's going to drive all the way through, and that's going to be a foul on Hudak, as that's Hudak's fourth. And Olsen, John, 6 points away.
That is very close. It's a lot closer than I thought it was going to get tonight.
As Olsen's going to be removed from the game, so she will likely not tie the record today. But she will have the opportunity next week, and she will likely hit it on Monday. What a fantastic performance by her.
And especially everyone else, too. Hudak, Tiffin, Boyer, everyone. They've had a great game tonight.
An absolute, just all-around outstanding performance as Springford is trying to close out this game. As Springford trying to get some more points as she's going to have open mid-range two, but going to miss everything as Mathakton's going to find a way to get some last minute points here. And that's going to be a foul. And one.
Yeah, great job by Timko, able to put the spin move, go up strong, and draw the foul there.
This is an extremely strong finish from Ethacton, who struggled in the beginning. But this is this shows how resilient this team is, even when their backs are against the wall. So Ethacton, had a fantastic night from the free throw, and they had a great game today as well, and not giving up. It's a huge part about sports. As Springford looks to close out the game, as we are a minute 30 from finishing up here. Springford passes it back out. They're looking to take their time while looking to put some more points on the board, as that pass is a little high. And Springford goes back on defense, and Ethacton will take it back out with a minute remaining left on the clock. Ethacton looking for a crease here to score, and it's going to go through the legs, and it's going to be Springford's ball. And we are at 50 seconds left on the game clock.
Seems like Springford is just going to try and run this clock out here in this last possession.
Hey, maybe not. These girls, they want their opportunity to score here. But they're going to take their time while doing so.
20 seconds left here. Kylie Lee just has the ball right up top, taking her time.
John, what an outstanding performance by Springford on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, both sides of the ball. They came out strong, played that full court press like we thought, had a lot of steals on their senior night, put up a lot of points. Everyone had a great game. Should be very proud of the way they played tonight.
Look, I mean, you had an outstanding performance from each one of those, from each one of the Springford girls. They did not miss a single shot. Ethacton also put up a pretty competitive game tonight. And all around a very historic senior night here at Springford, a very historic game, and we'll see you back here on Monday for Springford's fifth game of the season as they move to 4-0 tonight. Thank you guys so much for watching. I am Edan Castillo alongside John Zawislak. I hope you guys have a wonderful night and a wonderful weekend.
Superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for hanging on here for RCTV's coverage. Welcome back to the studio. Along with Dave Pence, I'm Bill Culp. And tonight, the Springford Rams senior night hold on for a 64-41 win.
Yeah, great game. Again, defense, forcing 19 Ethacton turnovers. Defense is key to the game. And the fact that Emily Tiffin poured in 18, but the leading scorer of the night was Olsen with 30, and we were in the studio. Is she going to get it? Are they just going to just keep feeding her the ball? And they it looked like at one point in the fourth quarter, they brought her back in. They were going to do it. But however, she's finished the night with 30 points, she's 6 points short of tying Sammy Stipa.
Yeah, we were thinking it's a perfect night, senior night, hoping that Coach McDaniels would start setting up some plays. Just wasn't her night. So it looks like Olsen's definitely going to eclipse that against Upper Perk here Monday. And they got a big pack matchup coming up. They got three games here, Dave, coming up this week. They got Upper Perk, PV, and then Norristown.
Yeah, big week coming up, and hopefully they can just keep this momentum and keep up this defense, that team hustle, that team mentality. Good quality minutes by a lot of players on down the line. Azara, Pettinelli stepping in when Boyer, got in that foul trouble and ended up fouling out. Good hustle, good rebounding, Hudak and company. Good boxing out. Didn't give Methacton many second chances whatsoever.
No second chances. So, before we sign off, I just have to say, I'm sure my co-host would like to say it too, but I got to give my condolences to baseball and the Aaron family, as Hank Aaron passed, an absolute legend. The home run game really was. Hammer and Hank. So, condolences to him. But congratulations to the girls as they extend their record to 4-0. And RCTV thanks you for watching, Dave Pence, along with Bill Culp. Tune in next week as Lucy Olson shatters that record.